First time I saw Kai was in Las Vegas in a back gym, and you know, obviously saw how athletic he was and how big he was, and just, you know, being 6'5 or 6'6 and having some skill like that, you know, and also being from Canada, knowing that he would be under recruited a little bit, we just felt like we'd have a chance to get him.
I think it was after my junior summer, I played in the Nike All Canada camp, and I got a little bit of information sent to me from them. And that's really where it all started.
For us, it was just realizing that with him being in Canada, that it was a chance for us to recruit him straight north of us, basically. Even though it's a long way from here, that area is just so under-recruited.
I really think after my two official visits, I came here and then I went to another school, Eastern Kentucky, and then just sitting back the week after that, thinking about where I wanted to go to school and how close it was, and just getting to know the coaches, I really, you know, had a lot of trust in Coach Nagy and knew that he would be looking out for me.
We knew that we needed to add to our athleticism. I mean, I think, you know, when you've watched Kai over the past 4 years, it's clear that he's been one of our best athletes.
The Regina, Saskatchewan native has taken on another role this season, that of a team leader and mentor to the younger Jackrabbits.
In terms of maturity, more so is just the physical maturity, and you know, I mean, when you're a freshman, most of the time you don't have that. Now Kai athletically already had that, and physically he already had that, and so that helped him.
It was a pretty big transition. I mean, the college game is so much more physical, so I wasn't used to that playing in high school. Everybody was bigger, you know, faster, so as far as the game, it was a big adjustment getting used to the speed and the size of everybody.
A little bit unfair for him and for Garrett to have to carry so much of a burden so early, but that was the case, and that's just the way that it's been. But at the same point, you know, I think it afforded both of them an opportunity to be, you know, some of the top scorers here and the top rebounders and things like that. And not everybody gets that chance. You know, it was one of the selling points for us to be able to recruit him, is that you get a chance to play right away.
Williams's goal has always been a team championship, and he feels SDSU turned a corner after advancing to the Summit League semifinals last March.
If it was any year, it was definitely last year. I know we had a lot of big wins, and we were competitive in so many more games.
When you have hope, which I felt like, you know, his first few years, there just wasn't much hope, and that was very tough. That was tough on him and tough on everybody. But these last 2 years, you know, we've had hope, we've had teams that can compete, and it makes it a lot more fun for everybody.
Talking to all the players and the coaches, I think that definitely last year we were making strides to make this program a contender in this league.
And he's on pace to become one of only five players in SDSU history with 1,000 points and 800 rebounds.
Overall, everybody wants to be on a successful team, so I mean, that's the main goal, but with having those things, it's nice to know that you'll be able to be remembered a little bit.
When you have one of your best players, it's important that they lead in practice, that they'd be one of the hard workers, and he's done that.